This
I thought you were going to sit down there. I know Mr. Boyce has already made a wise crack.
What's this? Is this a wide angle lens you've got on it? Just let me look through it.
Let David Bailey at them.
Right, can you both just
Ted David Bailey Hampton.
That's the end of that.
Yes, yes.
Hello,
Alison.
We're in the pink.
Let's go.
Okay, girls, let's go.
You can
can never get away.
She can see you now, actually.
Just lost the stone away, so you
have. Wouldn't that be nice? Okay, well, at least the sun's come out.
Well, there's no other action yet, anyway.
That's all there, yeah.
Marion.
Hey, Martin.
Hi, Al.
Fair enough. He's from the show.
See you.
Hey.
Hello there.
How are you feeling?
Hey, are you?
Good. I'm good.
This is Mike and Vicky. Just give me some sense.
Oh, hi. We're sitting with Vicky and Michael, is that right?
Michael here will tell you where you're sitting. These are Mr. Mills and Mr. Boyce, otherwise known as the Luds.
Look, how are you?
Hello, Elizabeth.
Hello, me.
You're on the stage.
Me? Yes, yes, normally, like every Sunday.
Mr. Mrs. Gaines, how are you? Me out of your seat.
Oh, are we?
Sporty, Mark.
Oh,
I wonder which one's June is composed of the girl in the dress. Jesse, would you like to take your seat now, or are you waiting for someone?
Alright,
forget your little bit, will you?
Aren't you?
You not forget your little bit?
You see me?
All right.
Yes, thank you.
Martin, will you repeat after me? I, Martin. To take thee, Marina.
To take thee, Marina.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And do in the presence of God.
And do in the presence of God.
And before this congregation.
And before this congregation.
Promise and covenant.
Promise and covenant.
To be a loving, faithful.
To be a loving, faithful
and dutiful husband unto thee,
and dutiful husband unto thee,
until God shall separate us by death.
Until God shall separate us by death.
Marina, will you repeat after me? I, Marina. To take thee, Martin.
To take thee, Martin.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And do in the presence of God.
And do in the presence of God.
And before this congregation.
And before this congregation.
Promise and covenant.
Promise and covenant.
To be a loving, faithful.
To be a loving, faithful.
And dutiful wife unto thee.
And dutiful wife unto thee.
Until God shall separate us by death.
Until God shall separate us by death.
As a token of the covenant into which you have entered, these rings are given and received. By these signs you take each other to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do you part. You again join hands. For as much then as you have covenanted together in holy wedlock, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce you to be husband and wife, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And what God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace, both now and forevermore. Amen. Congregation may be seated. You may relax. The duties which the estate of marriage chiefly impose is mutual love and reverence between man and wife. These duties are plainly set forth in God's holy word. And from that word we read, "Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Saviour of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband." We've read together from this book, God's Word. It has much to say, not only about marriage and married life, but about all of life. And in presenting you with this copy of the Scriptures, I say, take this book and on its wisdom build your home together. Martin and Marina, you know, perhaps some don't, that I'll not be preaching my usual length of sermon today, but I do want to take the opportunity to say something to you. We've already spoken together, but this is an occasion when others may listen in. First of all, to take the privilege of being the first to congratulate you both and to wish you God's blessing on your married life together, though there is still the little formality of signing the register. Sometimes when people look at the institution of marriage today, they're a little at sea as to how things ought to be.
Right, okay. Nice. to sing your maiden name, full name, right across. Marina Greta.
I'm signing my life.
So it's online now, so you know.
Right, just you sit there, Martin, come, if you come around here, we'll do the rest from this side.
I have to stand.
Yes, your full name, Martin. Oh, I'm going to smudge that. Yes, it is. It's very difficult to write on. Hampton, H-A-M-P. Right, again there. Right, June.
Was that you?
She's on. I hit the shoes on.
Just leave your shoes down over there.
Right.
Now, your full name, June, is your full name wrong?
No.
That's how you write it, just June McLean.
Yeah.
Okay, and once more on that line. Good, okay, Trevor. Now, again, your full name is. Good. Now, just one more wee thing, and then we're ready. We glasses.
Can't
they
fish?
Yeah, don't mind yourself.
Look, see, and Trevor John.
Oh, it's all come on.
TJ.
Right, that's it. Now you can pretend. Your mother-in-law says you're gorgeous, Marina. You know you have a mother-in-law.
Yes, her and more. We're very fond of John Pepper.
Okay. Right, I'll give you a chance together.
Okay, that's
get across.
Right.
Okay, pop in your trousers. Please stand.
Zero
problem. There's a lovely crowd standing behind the church. Sam Kennedy. Quite slow, London.
And you'll take well.
See you later.
Yeah. It feels really
fortunate.
is he?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's concerned about it.
Okay. I will have a nice cozy
drink.
What's it?
It's all over, Jane.
It's all over, Bobby. Shit.
Can we go through the rest? What's the camera? What's the camera? Can we get some?
Look around, I get a photograph. Right now.
All the best, best. Oh, shit. It's basically. Oh, isn't there something between us? That sort of appears.
Smile.
Who's doing the first day with? I think you're still as smart as ever.
Oh no. Never change.
What?
Never change.
Don't start doing this.
David.
Thank you.
Next round of point.
Next round of swing left again. Heifer, duck, signpost. That's the road.
Mr. Grimm. Your flowers are lovely.
It's all false, actually.
Hi.
Don't turn to me.
You're an amateur, aren't you?
I'm an amateur, yes. I'm one of the aunts.
Are you the ones from, one from America?
No, no, she's not here yet.
Oh, right.
Just got lost on the way.
I'm not getting it.
Hello, Mark.
They didn't kiss, sure they didn't.
Not in the front of the
not
church.
Not the search, not
literally.
Oh?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Every time you come
by, I'm going to kiss now.
We'll give her a kiss outside the church.
I didn't see it.
Did you not?
No.
Give us a kiss. Give us a kiss.
Did he get it? Got the sound up.
We do. That's a special. Thanks. What have you forgotten, thank you very much. Video cameras?
Not very functional, though, really, is it?
I have to go and do it upstairs.
Why?
I'll be all ready.
Your first song was Don't Touch. Give it a man. Playing up the car. Up the car.
I'll lend it to you.
Hello there.
Right.
Here we are, Liz.
There we go.
Take your flower off, no? Stella, you love her.
Put a date on it. Put a date on it. We'll all come to your wedding. It's about time. Sorry, am I embarrassing you, Mark?
You got Roberts to look forward to, haven't you?
Ah, no. How do we go to that?
Why not?
Too far away.
Give me a bit of excitement. We've got that microphone well away from all that wind noise. Smile.
Everybody, got 10, please.
Very cool.
Close mark?
Mm-hmm. Don't
be shy, I'm saying
it's getting boring otherwise.
Is that it? Good. You can gesticulate a wee bit, whatever you call it.
Pardon?
Gesticulate a wee bit. You know when you wave your hands around?
Oh, right.
Isn't it gesticulate?
Gesticulate, right.
Good. There we are. There's a word more, with more than four letters in it that I got right. Some people put it up with me.
Yes, that's what I want.
Lebs in the back now.
I'm looking at
it. We can observe that.
A bag of her dress is absolutely
yes.
Yes. Stay nicely where you are to get a side view.
No Dennis, no. Not in it. You gonna turn around and we get a back for you?
What?
You gonna turn around and we get a back for you?
Well, I wanted
to wear the 12.
Trouble with Mark's that one?
I'm not.
There's a black kid. Oh dear goodness.
There's several.
They're coming from all angles. So no.
Your ties classified dress.
I've now got 45 and a half minutes down in my 45 minute tape.
Have you?
So that either means I'm doing well or it's broken.
It's probably broken.
I saw one down in Argus. I had Argus. It's 300. Well, I don't know. What do you mean, on the camera? That's very good.
Just skip the night.
Is this it? Did I should cut it? No.
Don't actually cut it.
No, put a wee nick in it.
No. Probably just skip the dart with a knife.
Or move it up and down for you. Don't go.
Freddy's nightmares.
Sugar floors.
What?
Your mother made that?
No, Martha made the cake. Or somebody else decorated it.
So. And I'm going to eat it.
So you want them to be one thing?
Well, we're going to get one more into this here.
And then everybody else?
And then we'll go out to the far side, is that right, Norm?
Out that side?
Out that side.
Everybody? The whole party?
Get them out
the whole party or just the wedding?
No, everybody.
Everybody.
Come out.
Get those two ushers.
I said, I forgot about Alison Bennett at the wedding. He said, I told
him.
He's Jessup. Mark, you're not
funny.
You're not sure.
Put a funny face.
What do you mean, put a funny face? My face is funny enough. No.
Your mommy doesn't look at
the dark face. Who's that dressing
your husband?
No.
It wasn't rushed.
Since we started in
the church,
you just looked after.
I wasn't
happy.
Just because I stopped.
You said a few words.
Just because I stopped to get the car drove across.
Attention to David said he was on the way down to church in
the car. Yes, yeah. Try not to.
Important people first.
Yeah, I'm right here with that too.
You don't need a help?
Oh, I could do it.
Are they all in? Yes, that was very
thank you very much, fans. Autographs later.
You're very welcome.
Except you're so open the horse.
Yeah, everything.
But somebody has to hold it.
That's great. Who was that?
That in your pocket?
I said all the time. Wasn't
that Irene?
Yes, it's Sam.
Is you in order?
Thank you, William.
Did you get it? Did you get it?
Did you get
it? Did you get it?
I'll explain it all to you when everyone is here. Save it. Compulsory kissing now, you've heard it all before. Compulsory kissing. And when everybody's come through, then I'll come back to you and take you all down to the situation. I'll take you all down to the
situation.
Where's my phone?
Thanks so much. Okay then, folks, here we go. And there we go, well done, congratulations!
Thank you. just when there's a bulge in the conversation, I think perhaps now might be the appropriate time to start on that best loved part of any wedding day speeches. I'm not going to say anything at the moment, though I do reserve the right just to add a word later on. But it's a great pleasure, first of all, that I want personally to thank Gibson Murray and Jesse Crutchley for the invitation here today, and to say right away how much of a relief it was to be able to stand up and let that meal settle a bit further down. But also how much of a pleasure it was to be guests here today. Others will be wanting to say that as well, of course, but I'd ask now the bride's father, Mr. Gibson Murray, to address us.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have not been exactly strained at least to get to this moment, but I'm here. So, Marina tells me all I have to do is say how wonderful she is and welcome Martin to the family. Marina can do the first part of the show. It's a great joy for me to welcome Martin to the family, and Liz, and Ted, and Mr. Martin, and the rest of the people I've met today. I've always been very fond of Martin. I was thinking in church this morning as we were standing side by side, and Marina was saying I do, and Martin was saying I do, I was thinking, this thing between these two is getting very serious. But actually I knew it was serious, but a year and a half ago Martin laughed at one of my jokes. There's not a great deal to say, I just hope that they get even more happiness than they're entitled to, and that's quite a bit. A very wise man once said that when you come into the world, you're crying and everybody else is smiling. And with luck, you can live your life in such a way that when you leave it, you're smiling and everybody else is crying. I wish that on the bride and groom. I wish to propose a toast to them here now. So we should all pass.
I'm sure he's straining at the lead, so we'll call on him now.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my wife and I, she sticks in your mouth, that. First of all, I'd just like to thank every one of you here today for coming along and to share in this happy occasion. Especially I'd like to thank all those who came from England or from further abroad. Thank you very much for coming. I have also been very overwhelmed by your generosity of your gifts and the quality of them. And we thank you very much indeed for all those. I'd like to say thanks to Marina's Aunt Jessie and to Aunt Betty and to my mum for opening their homes and providing entertainment for all during the past few weeks. I thank you very much to that. I'd like to say thank you to Mildred for the beautiful flowers, for the arrangement in the church and here today. I'm sure you'll agree with me, are indeed very beautiful and very professionally done. Thank you very much, Mildred. To Martha, for who baked the cake. Drivers beware, it's a very potent cake. So thank you very much to Mildred, to Martha, thank you for that. To Valerie, who sang the solo. We heard it in the minister's room when we were signing it. Sounded very nice indeed, thank you, Valerie. Also to Eileen Boyce for standing in and playing the organ for us at such short notice. Thank you very much indeed. I'd like to thank also the ushers, to Ian and Michael, for their help today and for their professionalism. Ian and Michael, I think, are going to go into business and do ushers for anybody who wants them to. Thank you again. And to Trevor, my best man, for keeping me calm in the house today and for in the car coming down. Thank you for him and for his support and his help throughout. Thank you. Just a few words about Gibson. Surprised at how he welcomed me so much. Every time I seemed to be called down to the house, it was always fairly late on. And Gibson was always in bed, trying to sleep or maybe reading, peace and quiet. And he'd always come down very late and drinking his Horlicks on him and emptying all his tin. So to him, I say thank you very much for his kind words of welcome. for letting me into the family. I'd like to say thanks to my mum and dad for looking after me all these years, through the good times and the bad. Especially for taking interest in my music. While they were listening to it downstairs, I was listening to it upstairs. Thank you very much. Now, I promised Marina I would say a few kind words about her. It took me a while, but eventually I thought of something. I have here a short poem, and it's entitled My Beautiful Wife. It is said that marriage is a wonderful life when you take to yourself a beautiful wife. But soon you do find that this truth is dawning, that married life is all washing and ironing. Still, we're here today in holy wedlock, then off to the sun on full sun cream sunblock. Today is the first day of the rest of my life. It's a good job I married a beautiful wife. Then home to the house, to paper and paint. I hope all the work doesn't make me faint. But through all of the trouble and all of the strife, I still have the support of a dutiful wife. But hark and behold, I'm as mad as a hatter, for one day I may hear a wee pitter-patter of tiny little feet from a tiny little life. Oh, how I love my beautiful wife. Then we'll grow old and aged and wrinkled. We'll praise the Lord for the blessings he has sprinkled, the many years we'll have spent of this wonderful life, and I know I'll be glad I've had a beautiful wife. Just one more thing to add, and do you know, whenever the dresses were being made and organised, and they were joking about the colours, Marina said she was going to turn up in a red dress with a black armband, and some of the colours they suggest just got laughed at. But eventually one day I mentioned peach, and Mum gave it away, a big expression on her face, and so, yeah, you know, this could be it. So, it was denied, of course, very vehemently, and, well, what do you have? I have June here today in a beautiful peach dress. Well, I've been assured it's not quite peach, but I think it's close enough. To June, I'd just like to say thank you very much for your help to Marina and your support. And if you'd just like to join me in proposing a toast to June, who's indeed a real peach. To June!
Now, of course, it's not etiquette for the bridesmaid to reply unless she wants to. However, it is etiquette for the best man to do that on her behalf. And in calling on Trevor to do that, he's also going to read the greetings. Trevor.
Reverend Boyce, ladies and gentlemen, I'd first of all like to thank Martin for his kind words about her bridesmaid June. And I must agree, she looks very beautiful. Now, as best man and as a person married for 4 years, I felt the best thing I could do for Martin today would be give him some advice on the role of a husband. So, an interesting thing I found out when I was talking to some friends about this, I found out that the word marriage is actually an acronym made up of words, which are items, that define the role of a husband. Okay, so I'm going to run you through those. Now, you mentioned it actually in your poem there. The first task that a husband has to perform when he gets married is to take care of the pitter-patter of tiny feet when he moves into his new home. So for that, I've got you a mousetrap. Now, secondly, Martin has informed me that he'll be racing home every evening to get into the house before Marina gets home and try and get the meal ready for her coming in. But he's very concerned that he may not have it ready for her when he's already promised. So he may not have time to change out of his suit. So we didn't want him getting his suit messed up and getting himself into further trouble. So for this, we've got him an apron. So the second letter in marriage, A, is for apron. There you go. Okay. Wouldn't that suit you? Now, in case demonstration can't stand
it, that's it. No. Fair enough. I think, suit me, yeah.
Now, in case Marina comes in some nights from work, all stressed up after a hard day's work. The last thing that Martin wants to do is upset her any further, and he should always make sure he has at least one thing always in the house and always keeps a supply of it in the house. And that is Redox. So the first R in marriage stands for Redox. Now with the Redox, like any wife when they get near the bathroom, Marina's going to be splish-splashing around there for quite some time. And this will give Martin some time to practice the baking. So for this, we've got you a rolling pin. However, be very careful that you hide this when you finish the baking. If you ever step out of line, this could be used against you. So the second R in marriage stands for rolling pin. Now most couples when they get married for the first time complain of butterflies in their stomach. Now this is usually down to the excitement of living together for the first time and being in love. However, knowing that Martin has volunteered to do a lot of the cooking, I think it's more likely that it's possibly going to be indigestion. So the I in marriage stands for indigestion tablets. Now, it can only be expected that over a period of time, Martin's cooking will get better. However, with his mind continuously focused on Marina, gaga over Marina, it can only be expected that the odd meal will go wrong and possibly get burned. So for that, we've got some air freshener. So the A in marriage stands for air freshener. Now Marina, being the fair wife that I know she'll be to Martin, it can only be expected, so let him out one night a month with the lads. The last thing you want, Martin, is for the lads to catch on that you're developing dishpan hands. So the G in marriage stands for gloves. Now, the day is done, you've done most of your chores, and it's time to go to bed. But your duties as a husband are still not complete. And for this duty, you cannot be tired from doing the dishes. And you can't.